Good morning, my dear children. Welcome to the maths class of Standard 6. Today, we are continuing the chapter 1, Knowing Our Numbers. In today's class, we are going to discuss the exercise 1.1 answers. Okay, children? So, in the last class, I gave some homeworks for you and that is from exercise 1.1. So, we will discuss the answers today. So the first question was, fill in the blanks. 1 lakh is equal to -10,000. 1 lakh is equal to -10,000. What is the answer? 1 lakh is equal to 10,000. So 10 is the answer. Now second question, 1 million is equal to -100,000. 1 million is equal to, yes, 10,000. So here you can write 10. Now C part question, 1 crore is equal to -10 lakh. 1 crore is equal to -10 lakh. That is 10 lakh. 1 crore is equal to 10 lakh. 1 crore is equal to -1 million. How much? 10 million. 1 crore is equal to 10 million. Then 1 million is equal to -lakh. 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. Got it, children? Now the next question. Question number 2. Place commas correctly and write the numerals. So here the numbers are given in words. So you have to write the correct number and you have to put the commas also correctly in these numbers. So the first one is 73,75,307. How to write this number? 73 lakh. So first you write 73. Then put a comma, then 75,000, then write 75, then put another comma, and then 307, 307, this is another, 307 comes in one spirit. So 307, 10 spirit is, 10 place is not given, so 307, okay, so 73 lakh. After lakh, you can put the comma, 75,000. After the thousand, you can put the comma. And here, it comes the ones period. Okay. Now, next number, 9,05,41. That is 9 in crores period. So, 9, after that, you can put a comma. Then, 5 lakh. So, 10 lakhs place is not given. So, 05. 5 lakh, you can write as 05, comma, and then 41. So, 10,000's place and 1,000's place and 100's place. These all places are not given, so you can put zeros there. 0, 0, 0, and then 41, 41. Okay, this way you can write the number. And always remember, you have to put the comma after each period. And according to Indian system, the periods are 1's period, 1,000's period, then lakhs period and crores period. So, you have to put the comma after each period. Keep that in your mind. Now, next is 7,52,21,302. Okay. 7 crore. So, 7, 52 lakh. So, lakhs period is completely here. So 5 to 52 comma, then 21,000. So 21 comma, then 302, that is 302. So this way we can write that number. Next is 58,423,202. Okay, here it is given according to international system. okay, here it is in international system. Okay, so how we can write? Yeah, 58 million. Children, look, 58 million. That is 58, and 423,000. So 423,000. So that is in thousands period, and then 202. That is 202 in ones period. Okay. So here it is given in international system, so that's why you have to put the comma according to international system. Okay, that is after the ones period you can put the comma, then after the thousands period you can put the comma, and after the millions period. Okay, that means after each three digits you can put the comma. Okay, now next is 23 lakh 30,010. This is given in Indian system, isn't it? So 23 lakh. So 23 first you can write, and that's lakhs column, lakhs period is over, so you can put the comma. Then 30,010. 30,000 comes in thousands period, isn't it? So 30 you can write, then comma, and 10. So here the hundreds place is 0. So you can write 0 in hundreds place, then 10 here. Okay. So this is the way to write 23,30,010. Okay, children. And if you have any doubt, you can draw a place value chart, then arrange the numbers in place value chart. After that, you write. Okay. Then it will be more clear for you. Now the next questions, insert commas suitably and write the names according to Indian system of numeration. Here the numbers are given, numbers and figures are given. You have to write the number name of these numbers, and you have to put the comma also. Okay, so look at the number. You have to write the number names according to Indian system. Okay, so we know, according to Indian system, the first comma will come after three digits, then all the commas will come after each two digits. Okay, so this way we can put the comma for the first number. So how we can read it? Yes, this is ones period, thousands period, lakhs period, and 8 is in crores period. So 8 crores 75 lakhs 95,000, then 762. Okay, so how to read? 8 crore 75 lakh 95,762. Got it, children? Okay, now look at the next one. We know first comma will come after 3 digits, from the right after 3 digits, that is 1, 2, 3, after 3 digit first comma, then after 2 digit next comma. Okay, now look, this is 1's, 10's, 100's, these 3 comes under 1's period, and 4 and 6 comes under 1000's period, and 8 and 5 comes under lakhs period. So how to read? 85,46,283. Okay, 85,46,283. This is the way to read this number. Now look at the next one. Put the comma after the three digit, then after each two digit. Okay, now let's read this number. Here it is ones, here it is thousands period, and here it is lakhs period, and here it is crores period. So how we can read? 9 crores 99 lakhs 46. Got it? 9 crores 99,46,000. This is the way to read this number, 9,99,46,000. Okay, now look at the next one. From the right, after 3-digit first comma, then after each 2-digit you can put the commas. Now 701 comes in ones period, 32 comes in thousands period, and then 84 comes in lakhs period, and 9 comes in crores period. So now it is easy for us to read, isn't it? 9 crores, 84 lakhs, 32,701. Okay, how to read? 9 crore, 84 lakh, 32,701. Got it, children? Is it clear? Okay. Now we are moving to the next question. Insert comma suitably and write the names according to International System of Numeration. So, you should know the International System of Numeration, then only you can answer this type of questions. So, we know, we learned in the last class about the International System, and according to International System, the periods are ones period, thousands period, millions period, billions period, etc. Okay, so we know we have to put the comma after each 3 digits. Okay, so from the right, after each 3 digit you can put the comma. So after 3 digit I am putting the first comma, then again 1, 2, 3, after 3 digit I am putting the next comma. Okay, and this is the ones period, and this is the thousands period, and this is the millions period. So which is the number in millions period? It is 78, isn't it? So we can read it as 78 million. Then which is the number in thousands period? It is 921, that is 921. Okay, so we can read 921,000. Then it is 92. So read it as 78,921,092. Okay, this is the way to read this number. Now let's do the next one. After 3-digit first comma, then again after 3-digit next comma. And here it is ones period, here it is thousands period, here the number 7 is in millions period. 7 is in millions period. Okay, so 283 in ones period, 452 in thousands period, and 7 is in millions period. So we can read it as 7,452,283. Okay, 7,452,283. This is the way to read this number. Now let's do the next one. From the right, after 3-digit you can put the comma. So first comma will come here and second comma here. Okay, now here 102 comes under ones period, 985 comes under thousands period, and 99 comes under millions period. So we can read it as 99,985,102. Okay, 99,985,102. Now look at the next one. Here after 3-digit you put the comma. Okay, so here from the right, after 8 the first comma, after 0 next comma. Now 831 comes under ones period, 49 comes under thousands period, and 48 comes under millions period. So how to read 48,49,831. This is the number name of this number. Got it, children? Is it clear? Okay. So I hope everybody got the same answers. And if you got the same answers, you can put a tick mark on your notebook. And I'm winding up today. In the next class, we will discuss more questions of the next topic. Okay, so I'm winding up. Thank you.